Spinner is a very humble human being from Brooklyn, New York, born and raised in Brooklyn. Some may find it interesting to know that I actually have a Central American background. My family's from Panama on both sides. And I did live there for a year and a half when I was a teenager, but most of my life, of course, was spent in New York City. I got into music at a very early age, around 4 years old. It's always been a part of my life, really three. Three years old, I was already playing with records in my house. In school, I learned how to play several instruments, violin, clarinet, a little bit of piano. By 1982, 1983, I started learning how to DJ. So I've been doing this for a pretty long time. By 87, 88, I started learning how to produce. That's the beginning of my musical life, you know, playing records, DJing, production, and that's what leads me to be where I am now, you know, traveling all over the world, DJing, playing for many people, and bringing a lot of happiness all over the world. You know, that's what I was born to do. That's what I do. I have a lot of influences. God, just being around family. On the musical side, Stevie Wonder has played a major role in my life. Been listening to him since I was a child. And his music is very meaningful in many different ways for me, both on the technical side as a producer, on the melodic side, as a songwriter and composer musically. Also, the other person that's important to me is James Brown, because he laid down a very funky foundation. Everything that I do in life musically, James Brown is always there somehow. Like I always think about him when I'm making beats, when I'm DJing, I always play his music. And I have to also comment on Michael Jackson, because usually I wouldn't say his name. After he passed away, I realized that he's played a very special role in my life too. As a kid growing up, as a black kid growing up in New York, in America, he had the identity of the perfect artist. The new album is called Sonic Smash. When I first started producing and making records, it was primarily in hip-hop. You know, I embraced hip-hop from day one. It's part of the reason why I am who I am today, why I started DJing. You know, I looked up to Grandmaster Flash, Jammaster Jay from Run-DMC. Those are like two early huge hip-hop DJ influences for me. I care a lot about the culture, and that's why I made this album. It's been about 10 years since I made a 100% hip-hop album, DJ Spinner hip-hop record, and I've been wanting to come back to it for a long time. I do so many things. I do house music, I do broken beat, new jazz, I do a lot of soul music as well, but a lot of my fans who learned about me through hip-hop originally. That's how I started. That's how I came into the music industry, making a lot of hip-hop, a lot of underground records. And I kind of miss being in that world. I miss the community. The fans miss my sound, and that's why I made the album. It's out now. Came out about 2 weeks ago, and I'm very happy with the response that I'm getting from it. I think it's gonna do well for quite a while. Here comes the sun. When I was originally booked to do this performance tonight, I was told it was more on the house tip. Because of the release of my album and because of the fans here, my dad that I have, I was told that it would be best if I played some hip-hop as well. So, of course, I'm gonna start with hip-hop, but I'm gonna definitely demonstrate and display my musical background, my taste as a multi-genre DJ. So I'm gonna take you on a journey. I'm gonna start here, and I'm gonna end up somewhere else. You know, you might hear some break beats, you might hear some funk, some soul, some boogie, disco, maybe a little bit of jazz, maybe some 80s rock, who knows? Some house music, of course. Just expect the unexpected. That's my new slogan. I never like to predict what I'm gonna do, but you'll definitely be happy.